This is such a hearty breakfast. I think you have a breakfast like this, it puts you in the right mood for the rest of the day. This mutton curry makes for such a happy place to dunk this piece of ragi mudde.
It's raining cats and dogs here in Mysuru, and I'm here at Adi Pampa Road in BV Mohalla, and I'm here to breakfast and lunch at an eatery that's been around for the last 46 years. Tegu Mess began as an establishment to cater to the needs of students in the area nearly half a century ago. But today it draws patrons who flock here for the local style non-vegetarian food. So let's go in and taste local naughty style non-vegetarian food here at Tegu Mess. This narrow stairway leads not only to Tegu Mess, but also to the residence of the family that runs Tegu Mess. Tegu Mess is an extremely modest eatery in terms of its appearance, but as you step into the eatery, you can smell some delicious food cooking in the kitchen, which is separated only by a wall from the dining area. So as you take in the aromas of all that food cooking, it gets your appetite going and sets the mood for what will hopefully be a great meal to follow. So I'm going to go to the kitchen at the back and see what's cooking and also meet the owners, Mr. Tegoji Rao and his son Shyam. Namaskara sir. Namaskara. So idu nimdu amma start madidru
idu. Amma start madidru.
Although this place came up in 1971, they have been in the business of serving food since 1959. His mother began it and he continued it, and of course now also his son.
ನಾವೇ ರೆಡಿ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಮಸಾಲೆ ಎಲ್ಲ.
ಓಕೆ.
ನಾವು ಅಂಗಡಿ ಇಲ್ಲದೇ ಇರೋ ಥರ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸಪ್ರೇಟ್ ಆಗಿ ತಂದು ನಾವು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ರೆಡಿ.
ಸೊ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೋಲ್ ಸ್ಪೈಸಸ್ ತಂದು ನೀವೇ ಗ್ರೈಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಿ ದೇ ಪ್ರೊಕ್ಯೂರ್ ದ ಹೋಲ್ ಸ್ಪೈಸಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ದೇ ಗ್ರೈಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ದ ಮಸಾಲಾಸ್ ಅಟ್ ಹೋಮ್. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಮನೆಯದು ಟೇಸ್ಟ್
ಕುಕ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಆಗಿಂದನು ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಜ್ಜಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು, ಈಗ ಅಮ್ಮ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ.
ಹಾಂ,
ಮನೆಯವರೇ ಮಾಡೋದು.
ನೋ ಕುಕ್ ಐದೂರು ಕುಕ್ ಅಂತ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೆ.
ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡಿಲ್ಲ. So every gravy here is different. It is not that there is one gravy and it's all mixed together. Each gravy is prepared differently. Some with chilli, some with pepper, some with capsicum. ಸರ್, ನೀವು ಇದು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ಬರೀ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಮೆಸ್ ತರ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು?
ಮೆಸ್ ಅಂತ
ಮೆಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್
ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು. ಹೋಟೆಲ್ ಅಂತಾನೆ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು. ಅವಾಗ ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ 5 ಗಂಟೆಗೆ ತೆಗೆದ್ರೆ ರಾತ್ರಿ 10 ಗಂಟೆವರೆಗೂ ಇರ್ತೈತೆ. ಆಗ ನಮ್ಮ ತಾಯಿ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಮೆಸ್ ಅಂತ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ ಅವಾಗ ಬರೀ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್
ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್
ಒಂದು 150 ಜನ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ರು. ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್, MA MS. ಅವಾಗ ಭಾರಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ 71 ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಿಲ್ಲ, ಭಾರಿ ನಿಲ್ಲು. ಓದಕ್ ಬರೋರ ಹತ್ರ ದುಡ್ಡೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಊಟ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗಿ ಅವ್ರ ಕೆಲಸ ಸೇರಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ದುಡ್ಡು ವಾಪಸ್.
ದಟ್ಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಎ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ. ಸೊ ಹಿ ಸೇಸ್ ವೆನ್ ದೇ ಬಿಗ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಸ್ ಅ ಮೆಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕೇಟರಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಕನಾಮಿಕಲ್ ರೇಟ್ಸ್.
60 rupees ಪರ್ ಮಂತ್ 2 meals.
60 rupees ಪರ್ ಮಂತ್ ಫಾರ್ 30-31 days 2 meals. And at that time people didn't have money, but then eventually all these students rose to become senior IAS, IPS officers, and then they've come back and also continue to patronize Tegu Mess and bringing some of that fortune back to Tegu Mess. So he says people come here because they get the taste of home style food and even better than home style food. That's what they get here, and that's why people come to Tegu Mess. The food that's prepared by the family and served by the family, that is the care that goes into the food here at Tegu Mess. ಮತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ದು ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಇದೆ?
ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ 6 ಗಂಟೆಗೆ ಶುರು ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ಫಾಸ್ಟ್.
ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ 6 ಗಂಟೆಗೆ
ಶುರು ಆದ್ರೆ 10 ಗಂಟೆವರೆಗೂ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ತಿರ್ಗಿ 11:30 ಊಟ ಶುರು ಆಗುತ್ತೆ.
ಓಕೆ. ಸೊ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಗೆ ಏನೇನು ಐಟಮ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಸರ್?
ಇಡ್ಲಿ, ದೋಸೆ, ಗೀ ರೈಸು, ಪಾಯಸು, ಬೋಟಿ,
ಮಟನ್. ಲಂಚ್ಗೆ ಇದು
ಮಟನ್ ಮೀಲ್ಸ್, ಚಿಕನ್ ಮೀಲ್ಸ್, ಕೀಮಾ ಮೀಲ್ಸ್, ಕೈಮಾ ಮಟನ್ ಚಿಕನ್, ಫಿಶ್, ಮಟನ್ ಲಿವರ್, ಚಿಕನ್ ಲಿವರ್.
ಸೊ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಲರ್ನ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಡಿಲಿಷಿಯಸ್ story behind Tegu Mess, I can't wait to get to the table and taste some of the dishes on offer here. You got the ghee rice. Of course, that seems like a heavy start to the day, but this is a breakfast local style. So I've got my meaty dishes right here. Of course, I have the paya, the trotter, and then the chicken pepper, the mutton chops, and of course the idli is here, which is the staple, and that's served with a mutton gravy and also a chicken gravy. I'm going to begin with the paya or the trotters. I'm going to taste the broth of the paya first. I love the nourishing flavor of the paya. There's of course also that pepper. I'm going to get a piece of the paya right here. This paya melts in the mouth. This is such a great start to the meal at Tegu Mess. You know, I've been tasting a lot of payas of late. What I love about this paya is that it's so delicately flavored. You taste all that nourishment, but it's so delicately flavored. I think there's also some coriander in it, which gives it that fresh zing. I'm going to now take my idli and soak that idli nicely into the paya. That's how you capture all the flavors. Next, I'm going to taste some of the pepper chicken. First, the gravy with some idli. Oh, look at this chicken. This chicken has soaked all that masala. This is such a delicious gravy. There's a pepper, of course, but I think there's also some fenugreek or methi in this, which gives it that deep flavor. You know, chicken can get very boring otherwise, but this chicken is quite interesting on the palate. The chicken is cooked just fine. It has absorbed all that masala. This is such a hearty breakfast. I think you have a breakfast like this, it puts you in the right mood for the rest of the day. I think this is the same gravy that is served alongside. You don't need any of the meat. All that you need is a piece of idli and that gravy. That gravy has all the flavor of the chicken. Oh, this is so good. Next, we're going to try the mutton chops. You know, what's interesting is that the mutton chop gravy is much lighter in color compared to the pepper chicken. When you're cooking chicken, you always want to add more flavor to the chicken, to the meat, because the meat by itself doesn't have much flavor. When you're cooking mutton, well, that has all the flavor. So you want to just complement the flavor of the meat. You don't want to overpower that. And I think that's what they've done. This is like a stew, delicately flavored stew. That's what this mutton chop is. I'm going to taste a bit of the mutton now. You know, the mutton is soft to the touch. It breaks off almost effortlessly. You can see that pink meat. This is such a delicious start to the day. This is my first meal of the day. And I'm so happy that I'm tasting these dishes here at Tegu Mess. This is just brilliant. The stew is mellow in flavor. You have the onions. You have very light spices. What it does is, it just allows for the flavor of the meat, the mutton, to be most dominant. That's what this stew is all about. I'm going to dunk my idli into this mutton gravy also that is served alongside. That definitely packs a lot more flavor. You also have bits of the fat just to convey all that flavor. You know, the mutton chops were great. The chicken pepper though was equally impressionable. So I'm going to go for another piece of the chicken and that gravy. I love the way the chicken is cooked. It's tender, it's juicy, having absorbed all that masala. I love this dish. We have to taste some ghee rice as well. I'm told ghee rice is also a staple breakfast fare here.
I guess it goes back to this establishment's humble beginnings as a mess to cater to students. So when you're a student, you want that hearty first meal of the day. Budgets are limited, you have limited money, so you want that first meal of the day to be really hearty and sustain you through the rest of the day. So I guess the ghee rice is perhaps a tradition that comes from those days. I'm going to portion it into two and taste it in equal measure with first the delicately spiced mutton stew. So the ghee rice is made with a long grain, I think a basmati, and it is aromatic on its own, but with the mutton stew, it makes for a moist, flavorful bite. Oh, this is so good. I have to have a piece of the mutton now. I love the fact that you've got all the pieces of meat here have flecks of fat. So have some of that rice, scrape off all the meat of this soft bone or cartilage, mix that into the rice. That's a flavorful bite. The meat is cooked so well, it peels away gently from the bone. I'm going to taste the ghee rice with the remnants of my pepper chicken, the gravy here. While I'm at it, a piece of chicken too. This is going to be a full-on, flavorful scoop of rice. That is so good. Some onion just to break the flavors on my palate as I get ready to taste the next set of dishes here at Tegu Mess. So that was breakfast. This is now the lunch here at Tegu Mess. So the staple for lunch is of course the ragi mudde. Awesome steamed rice that you have here. There is some telisaru or rasam, some curd, some buttermilk. There's the two gravies here. There's the chicken gravy and the mutton gravy. But what we've done is we've also ordered a couple of sides. So I've got the chili chicken here. This is the chili chicken Maratha style. And then you have the mutton liver. And we have another mutton curry here. And what's always nice here at Tegu is that when you order a dish, they also serve you extra gravy with that. So this is the gravy for the chili chicken and then this is the gravy for the mutton liver. And of course some cucumber, some onions. We all need our fiber in between all that meat. I'm going to begin now with maybe the chili chicken. At Tegu Mess, there is no menu. They cook a few dishes each time. So maybe about 5 or 6 dishes for breakfast, 5 or 6 dishes for lunch. You come here and you ask what's available and you order accordingly. So it's a very simple way of ordering here at Tegu Mess. You definitely taste that chili heat, but it's more of a roasted chili heat. It's not the chili heat that comes from fresh green chilies. This is a sort of gentle heat that comes from roasted red chilies. That's what I suspect has gone into this chili chicken. There's also a copious amount of tomato in this chili chicken, explaining for that slight tartness that you have on the palate. It's a trifle big on salt, so I'm going to just get some lemon juice on that just to help tone down the salt a wee bit. A very different chili chicken from what you probably used to. I think next it's time to taste the mutton curry here. And I'm going to go in with the mudde. I must be honest, I don't eat mudde too often. I just find the concept of eating mudde a bit intimidating because with the mudde you don't chew. You dunk the mudde in some gravy and you simply swallow. But this mutton gravy, I love the way they spice the dishes. So when it comes to the mutton, even with the mutton chops and also now with the mutton curry, the spicing is gentle, the spicing is mellow because the meat itself has so much flavor and that's what they want to shine through. Whereas in the case of the chicken, you want to add as much flavor as possible to the meat. So the gravies or the spicing is much more robust. Just love that approach to cooking the meats here. Oh, so good. This mutton curry makes for such a happy place to dunk this piece of ragi mudde. I must now get to the mutton liver here. I'm always a big fan of, I love the intense flavor hit that you get when you're tasting liver. So it's in this green masala. I think there's some coriander. I'm going to get all the masala onto the liver. The fresh flavors of the coriander works so well with the earthy, meaty flavor tones of the liver. And the liver is cooked perfectly. You know, sometimes when you're eating mutton liver, it can be a bit hard. But this one is not. It has a bite and then it yields to the masala as you work it on your palate. Oh, this is so good. Time to go for the white rice now. I know I should be eating my white rice with this rasam and some curd. But looking at all these glorious meaty dishes here, one can't help but go back to them. So I've got some mutton curry here again. Go for a piece of the mutton as well. All that flavor of the meat is in this curry. And so when you have the curry on your rice, all the flavor of the meat is in your rice. I'll have some rasam now. It's got that tang and it's got that pepper heat. In this day and age when rice is considered unfashionable, we forget the fact that it is such a wonderful medium to carry all those flavors. Be it of a great meat curry or something as simple as a rasam. The perfect vehicle to carry all the flavors to your palate. The only way to end your meal here at Tegu Mess is with a glass of buttermilk. It's got all that coriander. Tastes so good. You know, I've thoroughly enjoyed my meal here at Tegu Mess. Every single dish that I tasted, right from the mutton chops to the paya soup, to the pepper chicken, the chili chicken, the mutton liver fry, the mutton curry, and not, of course, to forget the curries, the chicken curry, the mutton curry. Each of these dishes was absolutely delicious, tasty, and cooked with so much love and care. But what makes a meal at Tegu Mess so special is the fact that you're eating in someone's home. You can hear the head of the family here prepping the dishes at the back as he prepares to serve it to you with his son. You can hear the ladies of the house having a conversation as they're perhaps preparing dishes for the evening ahead. You really feel like you're dining in the middle of a bustling household. And I think that's what makes a dining experience at Tegu Mess memorable. So if you find yourself in Mysuru and want a hearty taste of local cuisine prepared Maratha style, do drop into Tegu Mess and savor all the wonderful dishes that are on offer. Until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and happy eating. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, share and leave a comment. If you'd like to support Food Lovers TV, do log on to foodlovers.in and hit the support Food Lovers banner. Links in the description below. Happy eating!